So we move on to our next speaker. I feel like I know this person. The fact we've rocked up with similar coloured hair today as well is just amazing. So when I say I feel like I know this person, I feel like I've hugged this person, I've networked face to face with this person. I feel like I probably have the same Buffy collection as this person. But we don't. We don't know each other. Lockdown was horrendous for so many things, but actually what it did is it made us jump online. And so suddenly I found myself networking with this bunch of geeks. Star Wars fans, gamers, geeks, nerds. And I was running this meeting thinking, this is crazy. And Lou rocked up into my world. And not only is she a Buffy fan and a Star Wars fan and Star Trek and everything else, and I just thought, wow. And actually, she said something to me after lockdown, which is, actually, I got the best referrals from that networking group because we were all connected by that thing we had in common, you know. And Shelley's talked about vampires and zombies and stuff, so you'd love Lou as well. Honestly, there's a book there somewhere. But we've never actually met in person. And it wasn't until Lou said it the other day, she's like, we get to hug and see each other. And I thought, wow, because lockdown did that, didn't it? It made us all feel like we knew each other really well. It made us all feel like we had to remember to, if we stood up, we actually got bottoms on. But it did a lot of good as well. So I'm really excited to hear what Lou's got to say today. I can't wait. And I love a bit of ice cream as well. Anybody else? Mike, obviously. Right, so over to Lou.
Sorry, can someone just tell me what time is? 10:03, right. So we know that the fire alarm's going off at 3, is that right? So what I'm thinking is because we're filming, if it does go off and I haven't quite finished, everybody just freeze in place. It'll make it really easy for us to cut it out afterwards. And I do love an easy edit job. So I'm Lou from Jellyfielders. We are a video and animation studio. We're actually based in London and now Colchester. But what I specialise in is content marketing, organic content marketing. That is content that you can use, make yourself, to promote yourself online. And we talk about the ice cream model. Now, Stacey's already mentioned that I became a gamer geek and nerd during the pandemic. I didn't become, I already was, but I found my people. And I know quite a few people in this room I've already met through that screen anyway. So it's really lovely to actually see some of you in person today. In 3D, it's a bit weird as well, but it's lovely to see you. So a lot of people have already seen my ice cream model talk, and if you haven't, I encourage you to go online and check out all the videos we've got there. But I'm going to quickly talk you through the ice cream model, and then I'm going to get onto a practical tip that I hope each of you will take away today and do before you leave. And I'd love to be able to go on the internet over the weekend and see all of you popping up in my feed showing me what you've done. So the ice cream model talks about four types of content that you need to market your business online. Now, you're probably thinking, well, you know, there's loads of different types of content. Sure, there's heard some of them talked about today. But in reality, there are only four types of content. So those four types of content are cornerstone content. That is who you are and what you do. That's explaining your offering in a very clear and concise way to your followers. And this is something that you'll put on your website homepage. It might be on your pinned post on social media. You might even have it as an email tag right at the bottom of your email account. There, so that when you email people, they can easily find out who you are and what you do. Second type of content is we call bragging rights content. And we've heard people talk about this today. This is testimonials. Testimonials, referrals, they're great for marketing yourself online. They're also great for your sales funnels, getting people to actually engage with you and really pushing people over the line on actually buying from you. Having a testimonial from a third party is just, it's just the best thing you can really have. Third type of content, resource content. Now, this is generally your blogs and podcasts. This is the sort of content where you prove your expertise to people. Now, we've heard a lot of stuff today about why people buy from people, how you market yourself. But ultimately, what people want to know is why you and your expertise are going to differentiate you. You from everybody else. Your personality, who you are, and how people work with you is what is going to make you be sellable to individuals. So your resource content is super important. And then the last piece of content is your active content. And that's what we're going to be talking about today. Because active content is the stuff that takes up social media. It's all that fodder that you put out. It's the pictures of your coffee in the morning. It's, you know, your pictures of your meetings. Who here is using social media and updating it regularly with the things they are doing? Yeah? Pictures, video clips maybe lives like we talked about earlier, blogs, podcasts. podcasts. We've heard a lot about podcasts today as well, all of which is great content. So what I really wanted to talk to you about today, which if you look at any of the materials, you'll see I'm listed as marketing, and that's because our actual title didn't fit, which is how to grow your online audience and generate leads using content you create yourself from business development activities you're already doing. So let's quickly break this down into three parts, because I think that'll make it easier to understand. The first part is content you create yourself from business development activities you're already doing. So content you create yourself, already talked about that. You can make your own blogs, you can do your own podcasts, your own videos, your own lives, take photos, make your own graphics. I mean, don't say anything about the designers in the room, but Canva is pretty good at doing some very basic things. Obviously, there are many suppliers like us and the graphic designers, website designers that can help you with this stuff. But there's always a base level that you can do yourself. And this is what we like to focus on for small businesses, because you don't have the budget. You might have a bit of time, but a lot of small businesses struggle to find the budget to pay suppliers. And what you need is you need a launch pad. You need to get it off the ground, and then you can bring those professionals in over time to help you build your marketing presence online. So, content you create yourself. We know what that is. Videos, podcasts, blogs. Activities you're already doing. Now, we're talking about offline activities. So one of the most obvious offline activities is something like a conference. You know, you're all in the room, you're all here. It's something you're doing to try and develop your business. But essentially, anything that you're doing for your business offline could be considered a development activity. If you have had some new business cards designed and you've got them designed and they're delivered, opening up that little box of business cards all new and shiny, that's a great piece of content that you can share. And we're going to come on to why that is interesting and how you can use that to build your audience and generate leads shortly. But what we have in our company is this kind of motto that nothing we do should be for one purpose. So if you check out our socials after today, you'll see that the stories has been updated all day. All day. We've had little clips, photos of everything happening. I've been updating it basically on a 20-minute basis. Mike is filming the talks, so they will go out on YouTube as full resources. We'll also do a highlights video of people here. We're going to interview some of you afterwards. We're going to track you down with our cameras and point it in your face and ask you questions. And you will answer, because we're very good at making people do that. So highlights reel, that will go out as well over the weekend. This event is a minefield of content opportunities, and everybody should be using it. But the problem people have is understanding how you use that content to build your audience and then generate leads. So there are a number of ways to do this. Marketing is just this ever-evolving, ongoing thing, and there are hundreds of different ways to achieve results. I'm not saying we've got the only way, but I'm going to show you one way that we have found great success with, that our clients have found great success with as well. So moving on to the next thing, growing your audience. Now, everybody on social media will be familiar with the look at me. I'm over here, look at me. Everybody's going, look at me, look at me, look at me. And so if everybody's going, look at me, nobody's looking at you because everybody's saying, look at me. What we need to do is we need to turn everybody to saying, look at him, look at her, look at them. It's the same as referrals. It's much easier to make a sale if you've been referred by a third party that that person already trusts. And the same goes for content and growing your audience online. You will only give that follow, you'll only give that subscribe to someone who has already proved themselves worthy of it. And one of the best ways of getting that proof is having someone they know say, go follow this person. A referral for social media. It works exactly the same. So what you need to do to grow your audience is you need to turn this whole look at me to a look at them. And you can do that by helping other people, but you also need it done in return. So that's how you grow your audience. Again, we're going to come to the trick shortly because we're going to put it all together. Generating leads. Generating leads. So we're going to go for beginners here because I know this has been mentioned a lot by a variety of different people in a variety of different ways in the talks you've heard today. But there is a beginner's way of generating leads, and those are to go to a networking event like this, and not just email people afterwards, but find them on LinkedIn and connect with them. Find them on Facebook and follow them. Find them on, basically become an online stalker. That's what you've got to do. You take their business card and you go find them on every channel they're on and you stalk them. That's your step one for beginner's lead generation. Step two, you've got to start engaging with their content. Like, comments, share. On their content, they put a blog post out, give it a like, share it to your audience. If it's applicable, obviously, you don't want to be sharing stuff to your audience that they don't want to see. Be discerning in what you're actually sharing. But, you know, you need to engage with it because no one's going to engage with your content if you're not engaging with theirs. Invite other people to like their pages. You know, I've seen a number of people today, a couple of the speakers and a couple of people I've been talking to on the breaks, who I think, actually, you know what, I've got some people in my audience. They're not necessarily ready to buy from these people, and I certainly don't know these people, that some of the people I've met today, well enough to refer them as a potential sale. But what I do know them well enough now is to refer them as someone who's got interesting content that might be informative and helpful to other people. So I'm going to share that. I'm going to share you. If you want to come up to me afterwards, have a chat, come speak to me. I'll see what you're doing. I'll share it to my audience. Because that is the way that lead generation online works for beginners. But I know you're not here really to listen to the beginners talk because everybody knows all this. So let's move on to the pro stuff. Pro lead generation. Now, when you go to a networking event like this, everybody's familiar with how you generate leads in the room, right? So here, I've done this for video because we're a video company, so it's easy. But this works for all businesses. You just need to figure out what your target market is. So I'm going to go into a networking event, and I've got three people here. We've got David. He's in construction. He doesn't use any social media. He hates it. But he does want a video for his website. We've got Gavin in legal services. He uses LinkedIn and Facebook. And, you know, he's considered video. He's umming and ahhing about it. He's one of those clients that we all hate that keeps coming back for one-to-ones over and over again, but you never actually finally get that sale. And then I've met Julie as well. And Julie's a graphic designer. She has said, I don't need a video. You know, I'm perfectly capable of making my own videos, make little slideshows and Keynote or After Effects, whatever it is she's using. She uses all social media platforms, which is great, but she definitely doesn't need a video. So when you go to networking events and when you talk about networking, when you see a networking presentation, they say, obviously the person I want to connect with afterwards. Oh, that wasn't too long, was it? That was nice. Pleasant. Okay, cool. So when I go to a networking event, obviously the person that I should be connecting with afterwards is David, right? He wants a video. So that is a hot lead. That's someone I can go away with an email and have a one-to-one with, which is great. And that is how lead generation works for networking. Everybody knows this. But when you're trying to lead generate on social media, you actually need to flip it. For social media, the most important person for me to connect with is Julie. And the reason it's Julie is because while she doesn't want a video, she has spent years curating and bringing together an audience of followers who are my target market. They're the people that I want to be in front of. So going back to that thing we said earlier, the look at me, the look at them thing, how do I get Julie to get her audience to look at me, to look at my socials? Well, it's actually really, really very simple. And it doesn't matter what sort of content you're doing. It doesn't really matter what sort of event you're at. You just need to create a piece of content with them. So here is a little list just to help you understand. We talked about live video earlier. Now, Facebook, yes, preferences live videos. And I understand why it's doing that. But let's discount live for now, because I know that a lot of people are a bit scared of it. It's a bit difficult to do. So let's just focus on content that you can go away and make and you can refine afterwards. Video with audio, that's people talking, interviews, is the most popular type of content. It's going to get you the most engagement. Next to that is video with no audio, so photo slideshows, anything moving and visual is great. Then you've got photos and audio clips, so your podcasts and things like that. People love that sort of content, but it doesn't quite perform as well as a visual moving image. Then you've got blogs, links, articles, and then finally plain text posts. So we understand, and most people are familiar with the order in which content is prioritized by the platforms themselves. So we're creating a piece of content. I'm going to go to Julie. I'm going to say, hey, Julie, you know what? I'm going to ask you a couple of questions about the event today. I'm going to see how you found the event. Or I'm going to ask you for your top tip. Who here has already been cornered by me and asked for their top tip today? Yeah, perfect. I'm coming for the rest of you afterwards. Don't you worry. I'll be there. So I'm going to ask her for a top tip. Maybe what I'm going to do is I'm going to combine multiple people into one video. The more people you put in a video, obviously you want to keep it within a certain length. You could say, I'm going to make a 90-minute video of everybody in the room, but no one's going to sit and watch 90 minutes. So you want to keep within your averages that we all know about. It's all easily researchable online of how long a video should be or how long a blog should be. But, you know, if you don't want to do video, you can ask for a quote for your podcast and get an audio recording. If you don't want to do anything to do with audio, visual, you're not an editor or anything like that, you can do a blog post and ask for a straight-up quote, just get a text quote from someone. What we're trying to do here is we're trying to curate a piece of content, one piece of content, from the event in which we can literally tag everybody that we possibly can. So we are going to share that content and we're going to tag everybody that's included in that piece of content. We're going to tag the event organizers, Stacey, we're going to hashtag BSN Conf 2023. We're going to tag in the venue as well, because, you know, they love sharing stuff. And why? Why would they do this? Well, the thing is, you're all sitting there going, well, obviously I'm going to create this piece of content, but you all want content, right? If someone says something nice about you online, the first thing you're going to go do is like it. Then you're going to comment and say thanks. And then you're going to share it. But all you're doing is giving juice to the person that shared it. So there's always incentive. So going back to the idea of look at me, look at them. The easiest way to get people to say, hey, look at this person, is to create a piece of content that just mentions them. It is that simple. So all the people that I've met today. And case in point, recently, I'm saying recently, it was 4 months ago now, we made a really big move from Southeast London to Colchester. If you know the hellscape that the London rental market is, you'll completely understand why we made that decision. But in moving to Colchester, I lost a lot of my business network, my immediate people in the area. So in Colchester, I thought, right, I'm going to go find an event. I found a networking event, Ambitious Women in Essex. I was like, I'm ambitious, I'm a woman, and I'm now in Essex. This is perfect for me. So I went, and I spoke to two people that there, got a little clip of them saying how great the event was. I spoke to Eve Calderbank, who is in Essex County Council, and she runs the event. Got a little interview with her about how important it was for the area to support women in business. I edited it together. It took me about an hour after the event. Put it online. And from an under 60-second video, we had, I think it was something in the region of 500 minutes worth of watch time on that. Which doesn't sound very long, but you've got to remember, people are flicking through, so they might only see 3 minutes of it. But it doesn't matter about that. We had 1,700 views or something on it. And this is the point. The views don't matter. The watch time doesn't matter. What matters from that is I received 4 emails after it. One from Eve Calderbank asking me to come back to future events. Great, she's going to introduce me to other people in the area. I received one from someone who runs a parallel event with Essex County Council. And by the way, both of them shared it online. That's Essex County Council sharing my video to everybody. I then had 2 more emails, both of which people asking for one-to-ones, both of which resulted in us giving them quotes. Now, with video work, there tends to be a 5-month lead-in, so I honestly can't tell you whether that's going to turn into a job. But the point is, I got to have that meeting with them. I got asked for a quote. I got asked for it. That is what a lead is, right? Problem solved. Got the lead from just creating the content. And this doesn't need to take you long. It really doesn't. You can spend a little bit of time making a video, photos, whatever it is. What you need to do is just make sure that you are tagging the relevant people in. And I say this strongly because I've said this and I've done this workshop with other people, and they've gone away and they've tagged everybody. And then they're spamming people, and nobody likes a spammer. So be discerning with it, be relevant with it. Make sure that the people that you are tagging are important and associated with whatever the piece of content is. Now I've said all that, you're probably going, well, that's all obvious, isn't it? But in fact, it isn't, because not many people are using this method of lead generation online. There aren't many people out there that are looking at the right target market and going, you know what, yay, David, you want a video? That's great, I'm going to email you, we'll talk about that video. But Julie, hey, you've got like 700 connections that all need graphic designers, and they might want video, so let's get in front of your audience. And every business has that. Every business has someone that's in their upstream. Every business has a referrer, and that's the best way to look at it. Who are the referrers for your business? Rather than just asking them, you know, can you think about who might want my services? Can you maybe email them? Don't just make a piece of content with them. Going back to that graphic designer thing, and this is my last point before I move on to your little challenge for the day, I said earlier about offline content being as simple as you've ordered business cards, they've been designed and they've been sent. Within that process, you'll have worked with a graphic designer, you'll have worked with a printer, maybe even a courier. All of those companies can be tagged in it, and all of them will be happy that you have created a piece of content, saving them the bother of doing it for the day. But it doesn't matter, and the reason I keep coming back to graphic designers is because if you're in B2B, graphic designers are a key. Because they work with everybody at a really early stage. So find the graphic designer in the room, find the web designers in the room, because they're there from the very start of people's business journey. So my challenge for you all today is to go away in the networking at the end, find someone, grab one of the presenters today if they've you know, taken your fancy, get them to do a little video, get some shots, share your photos, create a little, use Canva, whatever it is. Just share something and tag people in it. Tag them. make sure you tag BSN Conf 2023 and tag Stacey over as well, because we want to see her socials light up after this. And if anybody wants to tag Jellyfielders or come chat to us afterwards, just scan the QR code there and you'll be sent straight to my link tree with all the information and also a link to the ice cream model video where you can see the full walkthrough of our marketing strategy plan. Thank you.
Don't want to get in the way of the QR code there. Thank you so much. So I'm going to share another little story quickly before the break. It works. And I didn't know you what exactly you were going to talk about today, but it does work. So I had a phone call with Mark last week, and he put a LinkedIn post up saying, oh, I'm going to this conference, and this is in Birmingham, and da-da-da-da-da. And then Gary, who I've never met before, I might add, liked the post and commented. So I thought, who is this Gary? So I had a little look, and I connected with Gary. And then Gary, quite nicely, got in my inbox and said, hello, I saw you on Mark's post. Conference sounds interesting. And I said, it is interesting. And then we kind of batted around and stalked each other a little bit. And then I got a lovely email from Gary that said, ah, your Essex franchise. And we started talking about sports and things like that. And he said, I think I'll book a ticket. I said, I think you will. So he's here. And the good news is, I got told earlier, he hasn't fallen asleep like he did yesterday's conference. So that's got to be something. He's in the right room. But it just shows that connecting on social media can bring new people into the room. It can bring new people into your networks. And I'm really excited to speak about to Gary and Essex and sport, because you know we all love a bit of sport. So it does work, Lou.